Welcome to WebStarPress, how to fetch data from JSON file in React JS. I have created a similar video already, but this will expand on the topic further. We will display JSON data in React app directly. We will use JavaScript array map to display data. We will also use map inside map. We will fetch records from nested objects in JSON file. This is our React app, app.js. And this is the output. Let's create a separate JSON file and put some data in it. Inside src folder, new file, records.json. JSON is a clean data representation format. Anything that you write in JSON is valid JavaScript. JSON supports strings, numbers, booleans, null, arrays, and objects. To use data inside the JSON file, we take an opening and closing square brackets. Inside brackets, we take objects. This is one object separated by commas, second object, and this is third object. Object has got key value pairs. In JSON, we write keys with double quotes. Here is some dummy content. For this object, ID, title, and content. Key value. This is number. This is string. Key value. Data for the second object. Data for third object. Save. This is our simple JSON file. To display this JSON data in React JS, we import JSON file in React component by using any name. We will import it. Import, and this is the name, like whatever, from records.json. Now this name can be a meaningful name like records. So import records from records.json, the actual JSON file. Use any name instead of records, your choice. Period slash represents that a JSON file is at location where this app.js file is located in project. To map this, take curly brackets here and map JSON file data. Records.map. From this records, we name a single element as record. Then we'll have a fat arrow and curly brackets. And here we will use return. Inside return, we will display data. Let's use a class name, box, and then from this record, we can display the title. Title is this record. Okay, the title is being displayed. Now we don't need this. WebStarPress WSP and records. WebStarPress WSP and records. But we've got some error warning. Each child in a list should have unique key prop. So this is a record it should have a key prop. And that should be unique. Record.id. This ID. 1, 2, 3. Save. Reload. And now there is no error. Let's make the title strong. And we have the content. Content. Record.content. Save. And we have got the content as well. But here, let's use break, line break. This is better now. It breaks after content as well. Also apply a check here. Instead of just using records.map, use records and records.map. This is to check if we have data to map. If we have data, then statement will proceed. Otherwise, it won't execute further. It's important. Always check if data exists before displaying it. Now let's add some nested data in our JSON file. Next here, let's say tech, and this is array. And here is the object. After this line, we will use comma. Save. Let's use similar here. Comma. And let's use React JS here. Comma. Let's use Vue.js here, save. So now we have to call this as well. Now this, we have to call this name as well. That is inside this key. Okay, so we are mapping the records here. We will use map inside map. And this time we will not use this thing. We will use this record that we have got inside it. So curly brackets, record dot tech. From the record, we're calling this key tech, and inside this we want to map this name key dot map. Let's call it data. Fat arrow. Return records here, and it will be data.name. From this data, these values will be displayed. But inside return, we have to use something like div. And here we will use key. Key can be similar, this one, record ID, record.id. This is the key. Save. And here is the data from a nested object from JSON file. And again here, we will use record.tech and record.tech.map. I will show you what happens if we don't use this. But before that, let me explain this. The second map. We already have the object here. We will just extract values from it further. Instead of going back and starting from start, that was records. So that is why here we use this record. Because we already had the access to data, we are just going further down the line. This unique key. Unique key is needed for each record so that it can be identifiable by the app. We hard-coded unique IDs here. These IDs are hard-coded. But you can get a package from npm to better handle unique IDs. For example, UUID. And this records and or record.tech and are necessary because let me show you what happens if we don't use these. I will just remove this, hit save, reload the app, and nothing happens. But what if I remove one record from here? Save. What have we got here? Cannot read properties of undefined reading map. See? And now, if we add that back here, record.tech and save, then we have got our data. And if we reload the app, the error is gone. So this check is necessary. If the data is present, then proceed. So just take care of these few things. So bottom line, you can take any kind of JSON file with any type of data inside it, call it in React component by using any name, map its data, and display it easily in your app or project. You can even use JSON file as a temporary database for the React app. Okay, so I hope this video was improved and better from its previous version. I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.